What's going on, everybody? Jess James West here. Hope you guys are having a great day. Today, we are heading over to meet up with Stelios, and we're doing a Q&A. I posted this picture right here on Instagram asking you guys to ask a bunch of questions, and you did, so I appreciate that. So we're gonna meet up with them and get going with this Q&A.
I really hope that's Stelios.
He's back from the dead! Ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna do a Q&A today, and if you guys are OGs, you know exactly what we're about to do, because this is our first ever Q&A, was done up there. I spit on you.
Jeez.
Oh, that's so embarrassing. We did our first Q&A up there. I'm gonna put a little clip right here.
What's up, guys? Jesse and Stelios here, Farm Strings, doing a Q&A.
Insane.
I know, it is.
That's
nuts.
Like 2015. Yeah, I dabbed in that video. Yeah, we got some fans already, wow.
Let's get this started, come on.
Just real quick, who's got a cooler whip? Civic Gang or Mini Cooper,
all day.
Comment down below, Civic Gang or Cooper Gang. No, still. Just a little disclaimer, I got LASIK eye surgery, so that's why my eyes are like messed up, just saying. It makes me see clearer, they'll go away soon.
All right, you posted this 5 hours ago, so.
We got a good turnout on it.
2,000 likes and 95 comments, that's pretty good.
For a morning post, I'll take it. About a YouTube video. Guys, if you don't already, follow me at Jess James West on Instagram, Stelios, plug yours.
Yeah, Stelios Grudas right here. I know it's hard to spell, but just do your best, guys. Just sound it out. Stelios, O-S, not O-U-S.
Stelcorn.
Kick it off, we're gonna start with our buddy James Lynch. He had a pretty important question he wanted to ask. This one's aimed at Jesse.
Okay. James normally has some good questions.
He goes, hey Jesse, James here. Here's my question. Why is it that every time I try one of your workouts, something strange happens? Like the time I turned into a full-size lizard, or the time I became pregnant, or even the time I broke both of my arms. Listen, Jesse, I really enjoy your workouts, but it kind of seems like he's out to get him.
James, to be honest, I'm coming for you. That's all I can say. I am coming for you, James.
Really. Sorry, man, I've got the same problem sometimes.
Yeah, honestly, when you're turning into a lizard, there's really nothing you could do, man. It just happens. Like, maybe go watch some Marvel movies and like figure out how you can become a superhero or supervillain in some sort of way.
But hopefully that works out for you, James.
I'm sorry about your, you know.
From Faith Davis, if you could play any other sport, what would you play?
That's his girlfriend, by the way.
That's my girlfriend.
Just wanna
plug. Shout out Faith.
Hashtag Stel's girlfriend.
Follow her on Instagram. She's probably not gonna accept it, but it's fine. I would play basketball because I'm so bad at basketball and I wish I was taller.
Is this in college?
I don't care. I would play basketball anyway.
I'd play football.
Football?
I wanna be a running back again. I used to be a running back when I was a kid.
Back in the day.
Put in a little clip right here of me decking someone. All right, the next one from Maxwell Henry 02. How is it transitioning from high school to D3 or high school to D1? I mean, I can answer like both in a way, except for the spring portion, but high school to D1 and high school to D3, both of them are completely different. The college game is another level. Doesn't matter how good you are in high school. You could suck in high school and somehow become one of the best players in college, or you could be great in high school and suck in college.
Yeah. I think it's about like matching the speed of the game. I know everyone kind of says that, but it actually is a lot faster and like there's a lot of expectations that have to be met. Like in high school you can get away with things, but when you're in college, like there's a lot of expectations that the coaches are expecting you to like meet, like dropping the ball, like passing and catching, stuff like that. Like you have to be like,
you have to be like 100% on that stuff.
Yeah, otherwise you're just not gonna like see the field as much. But yeah, I mean, other than that, it's a lot faster, it's a lot more fun, it's a lot more physical, but I think that's kind of what everyone says, and I don't think you really know what it's like until you actually get there. So yeah, it's kind of hard to explain like through like a camera, but
it's all an adjustment. You just get used to it, really.
Yeah, like
at first it was like an extreme struggle, and then you get more used to it, more used to like skill level of play. I'm talking about.
That's like going from like
you just get used to it. Yeah, like of course it's hard in the beginning, but then you adjust and you learn how to play college lacrosse. Next question from Matt D. Olive 7. How many holes does a straw have? One or two? None. No holes.
Yeah, none. It's a tube.
It's a tube. It's not a hole. And tubes, if you think differently, comment below.
A hole is something that passes through a flat surface, probably.
Yeah, but it also has like an end. Like that's a hole.
No, dude. A hole. If you have a hole in your shirt. No, like it's not like
I don't know. I think it's like a tube or like some sort of cylinder tube. You
so
know
that's like
saying?
Saying a hole in the ground isn't a hole.
It is a hole,
but like how?
Because there's one entrance.
So what?
I don't know. I guess a hole is just something. I don't know. Okay, next question from Lucas Demps. Why didn't you play at the same college? Didn't really happen that way. We could have possibly played at some like two colleges, but it just didn't really work out that way. I committed earlier than him, so it just like it didn't play out perfectly. That would be really fun though, I'll tell you that.
It would be, yeah.
From James Spawns, steps on how to get recruited. Just be good and work hard and go to a lot of showcases, because
prospect days are really
there are no steps. You have to be good, first of all. Not to be blunt.
Yeah, a lot of kids think, oh, how do you get recruited? You should focus on getting better, and then the recruitment like process will happen.
Yeah, you'll find somewhere.
If you get good.
From BC Lamb, when sign makers go on strike, is there anything written on their signs? If anything, there's written, there's no signs. Think about it.
Wait,
if a,
what?
If a sign, if I make signs and I'm going on strike, how do you go on strike? If you, you can't use a sign.
So you're going on strike to stop making signs.
Even though you're using a sign.
Wow.
You're just in, you're stuck there forever. That's all I can say.
Dude, what kind of questions are these? Jeez, these are freaking like
from
brain
Jared,
teasers.
I know, it's like.
They're brain teasers.
From Jared Chapman, what's the worst injury that you have faced?
Oh, knock on wood here, it's not. I've had a few. One was a really bad sprained ankle, which is fine. I got over that. Like,
yeah, but you tore, no, you tore stuff there.
Yeah, I tore like three ligaments in my ankle, terrible.
That ain't no sprain.
Yeah, and then I tore my meniscus, which was like, a long, like it's a quick recovery, but like it just like takes a while.
Drags on.
Yeah, like it still hurts like to this day sometimes. It's just like the padding between your knee, it just like erupts and like you just lose it. You like don't get it back. It doesn't grow back, so.
Yeah.
It still kind of hurts, but that's pretty much it.
Say tearing a tendon that like kind of like attaches from your hamstring to your glute. I tore that in eighth grade and it lingered all the way till like nearly spring of almost sophomore year just because it would always come back and hurt. It was not gonna be torn again, hopefully, but like it just would always ache and like literally.
There's a lot of ligament issue.
All right, now we're gonna move somewhere else.
Ba-bow,
ba-bow,
ba-bow, ba-bow. Who's winning in a rap battle? I would say Jesse, because Jesse is just a master of freestyling. You really want to get into a piss and match with the trappity rat pack and the mac and
sometimes, yeah, I wouldn't
say he puts together the best sentences. Some of them don't make any sense.
But they sound like
but,
they do.
He's got some flow, so I mean, I would say Jesse would win a rap battle.
I was gonna say I'd win a rap battle. Maybe we'll, if you guys wanna see a rap battle, let me know.
Stevenson 5, why does a round pizza come in a square box? Enough with these brain teasers, guys.
Guys, I know, but I did say get creative and funny, and you guys are doing really
well.
You're
doing well.
You're slumping us.
Here's my theory.
Slumping?
If you're ordering a pizza box, okay, a box, how do you make a, I mean, I guess you can make a round box, but like, okay.
Yeah, you really can't like fold that, like it's gonna be octagonal.
Yeah. What do you do in your free time other than lacrosse and the gym? From Kevin Quigley.
I scroll on social media. No, I do work, I coach lacrosse, and I do videography for a DJ company, but yeah, I kind of just do two things in my life.
Life is busy, you know?
Yeah, I work or do those two things and hang out with friends at night if I can.
Try to hang out with as many friends as possible. I'd work too.
You work, he hangs out with the girlfriend.
Hang out with my girlfriend. Who would be better at goalie from Lane Smith 29?
Stelios.
Me, I used to crush it in the backyard back in the day. Everyone wants to see videos of that. I don't know why.
If you guys want to see Stelios shoot on me and me shoot on Stelios, like,
okay, we can make that
drop a like and comment down below. Just do it.
I would save everything.
I'm too afraid of the ball. My life is too valuable.
From
shout out to the goalies out there.
How much dip do you have with your chip?
I'm a minimal dip guy because I like to. Yeah, I'm a minimal dip guy. I just like kind of let it get a little bit on there. You know,
I'm a big scoop guy. I like the scoops and I just scoop that up. I like the queso. What is it? Salsa con queso, great stuff.
All right, who would win in a fight, Stelios or Jesse? We always ask each other this question and kind of like try to figure it out. My ego wants me to say myself, but I feel like I don't want to fight Stelios, I'll be honest.
Yeah, but I feel like if Jesse was really, really mad, he would probably just kill me with like one punch. But, but like, I don't know. It depends on like what the situation is, but I don't think we'd ever like
I don't have the, fight. If Stelios hit me, I'd probably just be like,
like, dude, chill.
I'd be like, dude, calm down. Like, I'm not angry at you.
Yeah, I don't think we'd really like fight.
This guy's kind of mean. I'm just gonna say, he's kind of calling me out.
Haters.
Got some haters out here. Why are your calves so small?
Genetics, bro.
Well, the angle's terrible. Ready?
Dude, those are fine.
Hold on, Stel, I'll be right back.
There's an ant on me, bro.
Stel, I'll be right back, okay?
I think you made him a little insecure, so I think he's just gonna do some calf raises.
All right, meet. Good. How much wood can a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could? Oh.
You can't even say it. How much wood could a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood?
Ha. How much wood could a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could wood? How much wood could a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could wood?
You can't say it.
How much wood could a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could wood?
You can't say it.
How much wood could a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could duck wood? I almost had it.
If a woodchuck could wood.
Okay, next question.
You got brain teasers, like freaking.
Dude, you guys are killing us.
Tongue twisters, right, everything.
From Tyler McCreary, when are the meet and greet tickets going on sale?
Yo, they're live right now. Link in bio. Make sure to pick them up.
guys, just if you want to come to my meet and greet, just swipe up. Hashtag ad.
From Lacrosse King 568, out of the two of you, who is the better cook? I'm a chef, dude. I like to make pancakes.
Guys, he owns the restaurant right over there. Literally owns the restaurant. Like, how do you excuse me? All right, next one. Hit me. Punch me in the face. Skateboarding or scootering, Stell?
Scootering.
Dude, rollerblading.
Scootering, man.
Rollerblading.
Jesse's a skater.
Yeah, no, I would skateboard. Who got the harder shot? Not me.
Ha, your boy does.
Listen, guys. Listen, guys, the one thing I can one-up Stell in lacrosse is assists.
Yeah, that's a fact. I don't assist the ball as much.
In high school, I threw him
the
ball.
This is what Jesse does. Behind the back. This goes out for the most random question ever.
Of the day?
Yeah, from Lax George. Would you rather be an astronaut for 1 year or have to eat a piece of bread after every quarter of a lacrosse game? Most random question ever.
That's so weird.
I would eat bread. I'd be an astronaut, dude. Dude, you can eat bread whenever you want. How often do you get to be an astronaut?
I know. I feel like I have to face my fears and do that. You know what, Yes Theory? Let's go to space.
Screw it.
Just calling out Yes Theory, tag them.
Does Mike Wazowski wink or blink? Get it? No. He has one eye. Does he wink or does he blink?
Nah, it's a blink. Yeah, his wink is probably special somehow.
He only has one eye. Who would win in a 1v1 from Stephen Cali 20?
Oh, sorry. 1v1 like me versus you?
Yeah.
You always beat me in the backyard. Guys, I told you, I only win at the assists.
Jesse's a game player only. No, not practice player.
Yeah, I'm not a practice hero.
Yeah.
Oh, agile.
All the strength in my left calf.
Oh, that will get hurt.
I just ripped my knee. This is actually a great question. From Aiden Siever. I like your maturity. He goes, what kind of challenges do you think the next generation will face?
Ooh,
very interesting.
That's a good question.
So I think the biggest issue nowadays is social media. Because I think a lot of people are getting too caught up in that.
I think it's like the social acceptance of it.
Yeah, being accepted through social media and getting likes and all that stuff. I think that's a big issue. And I think another thing is like communication. I think everyone's good at communication nowadays, but I think we're good at communication in the wrong ways. I think personal communication is not really as strong as it used to be. Now it's like all through phones, which isn't a bad thing. Like, I think we're able to reach and talk to like as many people as possible, like all over the world, but
yeah.
I just feel like the personal connection.
No, it's not like it used to be how people like are face to face. Now you have you can hide behind a screen and do things.
But yeah, other than that, I mean, I think society hopefully will figure itself out and it should be good.
Can vegetarians eat animal crackers?
Yes.
From Zach 14, will you ever grow out your hair again? That's a negative, sir.
Why?
Because that was ugly as hell. How do you guys say water?
Water.
Water.
No.
I say water.
Where did you guys meet?
How many times am I gonna tell this story?
It was a long time ago.
Yeah, long time ago, Jesse and I, you know, my grandma lived right down the street from Jesse.
Oh no!
No, see, that's why I'm asking you. That's why I'm asking you.
Jesse doesn't even remember this.
I don't remember, I'm really sorry.
So, I was probably like in fifth grade, I would say. Fourth, fifth grade?
Probably fourth.
Fourth grade. So I never met Jesse before, and then I went to a skate park one day, and Jesse was sick at skateboarding when we were younger, and I was terrible, so I would just like go there and like do whatever I could, and I would just like watch other people. And Jesse was just doing like kickflips and all this like crazy stuff, and I was like, yo man, like what's up? Like you can do a kickflip? Like that's crazy. And he's like, yeah, and I was like, what's up, man? That was it. And I moved on. And I realized that was him. And then fast forward a couple of years, I went to his house and we hung out, and because he lived right by my grandma, and I walked up to his house. Asked him to hang out, and the rest is history, you know?
Didn't we climb a tree?
We climbed a tree.
We climbed like a tree in my front yard to hang out, and that was that was our first hangout, and that's how we met. It was hilarious.
From Josh Panfil, what made lacrosse a sport both you guys liked more than others?
All right, so I love individual sports, bodybuilding, skateboarding, all those extreme sports I used to do. So, like, it had the aspect of, like, a personal sport, like a one, like a just you sport, but it brought it into, like, a team sport. So it was very fun. And I just loved, like, the creativity and, like, and how, like, intricate everything is. Like, the sticks to the movements and everything is very, very particular and intricate.
I think I also love the lacrosse community. I think everyone does a good job with that. And, like, everyone's very close-knit because it's not, like, huge, but I think it's everyone's great. Everyone who plays the sport's great. It's a really fun game, and that's pretty much it, yeah. Mark Ranieri, this one I think is going to Jesse. Have you ever thought about going not natty or not natural, like in lifting?
You know, I thought about the magical beans.
No, I'm kidding. I would never take steroids. I really have no interest of A, being that big, B, competing at that level. When I'm older, maybe I want to compete, but like, I don't know. It just, I don't think.
It takes the fun away from me, you know?
It takes the fun away, because like the whole fun of lifting and putting on muscle and getting stronger is like the struggle of it and like it being so hard.
Yeah.
So I don't plan on doing
like
anything. Yeah.
Too.
Not only is it illegal as an NCAA athlete, but like it takes the challenge away. And if you're not being challenged, like I don't find it fun. So I am natural, by the way. All right. Shout out John Henry Finkel.
John Finkel D, the beast.
My man. I coach him, by the way.
Really? That's sick.
He says I still have bigger legs. You know what? You do, man.
He probably does, dude. The kid's a beast.
How many days a week should I lift to gain weight? From Brendan Batavio. 4 to 6. You could do, dude, honestly, just get in as many days as you can. Always have one day off day.
Just, yeah, make sure you're not getting overtrained.
What do you think about the no shoulder pads for the PLL? I think it's fine because I'm gonna be honest with you guys, there's a ton of Division I players that don't wear shoulder pads.
Dude, you don't need shoulder pads.
Should I be worried about counting calories and trying to cut at 14? Absolutely not.
Enjoy your life at 14,
dude,
guys.
Dude, you're 14 years old.
Enjoy your life.
Just eat as much as you can and lift if you can. There's no point of cutting at 14 unless you're actually like holding a lot of body fat. Other than that, just do your thing. From Alexis Kuzo, you guys crack me up. I want to make a video with you. We got to make some videos together. We should collaborate.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to be in Maryland, you know, coaching Lax, so.
Yeah, shout out to Alexis Kuzo. She has some sick stuff.
From Drew Geisinger, day or night? Day. Sun or moon?
I'm a big night guy, dude. I'm a big night guy.
Sun or moon? Sun.
That just shows the difference.
I just like, I don't know, nighttime, like, I feel just like I need
day.
I need day to be productive. I do
stuff till like 2 a.m. like every night. I'm on my computer, I edit, I do everything. It's like so late.
From Rover Tyler, dating advice. Don't ask me.
Just,
he's the one with the girlfriend.
They're worth
it. Guys, you're young. Just have fun.
You're young. Have fun. Make sure they're worth it.
Tacos or burritos?
Burritos.
Tacos, homeboy.
I like soft shell tacos. That's the way to go.
No, hard shell, guys.
No.
We are nowhere near alike anymore.
Dude, I know.
What has Villanova done to him? You will make a mass collaboration with Mitchell Pelkey, Katie DeFeo, and Tohoka. I'm going to be honest. The odds are high.
Yo, throw RJ in there too while we're at.
Yeah, RJ Kaminsky, where you at? We're going to be in LA at the beginning of August.
Guys, come out.
Hell yeah.
We'll do a meet up there.
Well, dude, we'll make a Team 10 house.
That'd be unreal.
It'll be like a Lax house, Team 10. What made you choose Montclair? Just loved the atmosphere there. It was a great opportunity. It's close to home. That wasn't really a deciding factor, but it just like worked out really well. And most importantly, affordability. What's the biggest struggle in college?
Biggest thing is time management, you know? Like getting up for lift, going to class, doing homework, having practice, it all adds up. Days become very long.
Especially at the D1.
Especially D1, well, yeah. Like even D3 though too. It's just a lot of work. You gotta make sure you manage your time well, make good decisions. I think a lot of kids make a lot of the mistake early on of like choosing the wrong things. Like
There's three aspects.
There's
school,
three, yeah.
Athletics, and social, and you can only do two well.
Yeah, so if you try to do all three, chances are you're not gonna be as successful. If you just pick two and go with it.
And if you're like, wondering why I left D1 is because I was balancing like 7.
Yeah, exactly.
And that doesn't work.
So if you want to do social and school, maybe a sport in college isn't the way to go. If you want to do school and sport, then maybe D1's the way to go. It just really depends on what you want. You can't have
all
three.
I'm always trying to tell kids, like, don't put aside D3 lacrosse because 3 becomes easier to handle because there's less of athletic. Less athletics gives you more social in school. So you pick and choose whichever one you want to put it towards. Why it worked for me, because I'm trying to put it towards A, school, but B, I'm trying to put it towards other goals I have, like social media and just, you know, just enjoyment of college experience. All right, guys, that's gonna wrap up today's Q&A with Stelios Crudis. I know, as I just dodged that thing. I hope you guys have a great day. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe.
Be sure to subscribe to Jesse.
Subscribe to
my channel as well.
Yeah, guys, Stelios will be linked the first in the description, so make sure you guys subscribe to his channel. My shoe just came off because he stepped on it, but we're gonna keep moving. Anyways, make sure you guys comment to Civic Gang.
Mini gang, let's go!
Who wins?